Most of you watching this video probably already own Automobilista 2 or Project Cars 2. If this isn't the case, then you are most likely on the edge of acquiring either one of them, but I'm not sure yet which game is a better fit for you. So to help you make a decision or to reaffirm one you already made, we are going to go over the most important aspects of both games, split them into 5 categories and directly compare them. These are the following: the overall graphics of the games, the sound of the cars, the physics slash the handling of the game, the multiplayer, and finally, the available content. According to the list just shown, we are going to start off with the overall graphics. It should be no new information to you that both games should be pretty darn similar to each other in this area, due to both having the Madness engine as the fundamental, which also plays a role in their respective physics, but more on that later. When Project Cars 2 released way back in 2017, it was undoubtedly the most beautiful looking game on the whole sim racing market. Crisp clean visuals, amazing night shaders, even rain was never looking better. However, these features all came at a rather high cost. They needed a whole lot of computation power, and it also became clear that some areas of the Madness engine weren't perfectly optimized, which in turn forced you to either upgrade your graphics card or allow some aliasing effects and blurred textures. Nevertheless, at the time, it's safe to say that Project Cars 2 graphics dominated the sim racing market on PC. Automobilista 2, on the other hand, should therefore have a slight disadvantage against its current competitors, as it has to run on a 3-year-old engine instead of a newly created one that would be up to current day standards, right? Well, theoretically speaking, this argumentation would be bulletproof, but somehow the Brazilian team behind Reiza Studios managed to squeeze even better performance out of the Madness engine. Everything is decently optimized, and even a GTX 1060 is able to run the game with stable 90 FPS at the highest settings. However, these optimizations obviously come as a trade-off. Yes, higher graphics settings are more easily achievable in AMS 2, but the maximum visual potential is greater in Project Cars 2. In the end, it really comes down to slight differences between them. Project Cars 2's tracks, their surroundings, and even the cars themselves are a lot more detailed and clean looking than their counterparts in Automobilista 2. However, if performance is your main concern, you may have to allow for some aliasing in Project Cars 2, whereas Automobilista 2 would still be fine on higher settings. So yeah, considering all of this, I'd reward Project Cars 2 the first point, simply because it has the potential to be more immersive regarding its graphics. Moving on now to the next point, which is the sound simulation in both games. For this, I'm just going to let 2 15-second clips play without any interference from my side and draw my conclusion afterwards. To me, Project Cars Specimen felt like it just used a generic sound sample that is slightly changed depending on the vehicle in question, whereas Reiza put a bit more effort into making each and every car sound more unique and realistic. Therefore, AMS2 wins this category and equalizes the scoreline. The next point of comparison is probably the most important part of defining the success of a racing simulation: the physics and how well the cars handle. For Project Cars 2, this has always been a weak point, where the opinion of the sim racing community rather saw it as a sim-cade game than an actual simulator. When you first jump into this game, you'd probably just be an additional voice repeating their words. However, the truth is that actually both games, Project Cars 2 and Automobilista 2, suffer from the same inconveniences. Their default setups for every single car are pure garbage. Let me just show you a clip of me driving the SS at the Circuit of the Americas. Notice how I have to avoid the curbs at all costs, because they would instantly spin me out otherwise. However, let's do the same section again, but this time with a modified setup. Here, the curbs are still shadier than they should normally be, but somewhat drivable. So in conclusion, Project Cars 2's curbs are quite iffy. The cars are all extremely unstable, especially with cold tires, and without any knowledge of basic setups, you are pretty much left stranded. But let's not forget the one thing that made the Madness engine stand out. Lifetrack 3.0. This feature is set to take into consideration things like shades casted from trees, gradients in the track itself, and more elements to update the track conditions individually. So if you were to drive at a sunny day, but one corner is surrounded by trees and therefore not directly hit by the sun rays, this very part is going to have slightly less grip due to its surface being cooler than the remainder of the track. As stated before, Automobilista 2 runs on the same physics engine and therefore also has access to the exact same features. However, its cars all drive fundamentally different. The default setups are still pretty bad, which mostly leads to massive oversteer, but the one thing Reiza nailed is the curb behavior. In Project Cars 2, even with the perfect setup, curbs are a gamble to take, whether they'll spin you out or let you pass on. This most definitely is not the case in AMS 2. If you spin out, it's 100% your fault. So to conclude, both games are similar in their driving characteristics, where cars are quite difficult to drive smoothly. But I'd say that Automobilista 2 has an edge over Project Cars 2. Mostly because you can actually utilize curbs, and all tracks feel less slippery overall. Another point for Automobilista 2. What also can make or break a game is the multiplayer. Whatever great content a simulator provides doesn't really matter too much, as sooner or later people usually want to compete against other human beings to judge where they currently stand, or just because racing AI opponents got too boring. There are currently two major multiplayer models out there. Scheduled races managed by the producers and a server browser. Both Automobilista 2 and Project Cars 2 are using the server browser model. However, Project Cars 2 also features a multiplayer license that basically logs how quick you are. It's a very basic implementation of an ELO system. Multiplayer lobbies are always visible in the server browser, but can be password restricted or have a minimum license level as requirement. If you find a fitting lobby, chances are there are one or maybe two guys that are around the same speed as you, where the rest is either way faster or way slower. For Automobilista 2, things basically are identical, except that it lacks a multiplayer rating system. I don't know why, but initially Reiza stated that AMS 2 will release with one already in place. Then at its official release, which already was delayed due to COVID, they published a statement saying they weren't able to finish it in time, but it is going to come out in December of 2020. And guess what? In November, an identical statement was released, postponing it further to the first quarter of 2021. Now, at the point of me creating this video, it's already mid-February 2021, and there is still no new sign of a rating system, which is why I'm just going to pretend that there will never be one. However, what I think is a great addition by Reiza is that they are planning to make all DLC contents free for their multiplayer. Meaning, if you don't own any DLC but want to drive a race at the Nürburgring, you can join a lobby and be fine. The only limiting factor is that you yourself cannot create a lobby containing a car or a track you don't own. So joining is fine, creating not so much. But please keep in mind that this feature is not yet implemented, but Reiza plans on doing so. So to award a point here to either of the two parties is rather difficult. Project Cars 2 has more active players, which in turn also means more online lobbies, and at least some kind of rating system, whereas AMS 2 on the other hand will probably allow you to enjoy its full content online, without needing to purchase a DLC. In the end, I'd say the point has to go to Project Cars 2, simply because this feature in AMS 2 is not yet implemented, and if it goes along the line of the multiplayer rating, the earliest it could launch is probably around mid-2022. However, if the multiplayer rating or the free multiplayer DLC usage patch are released, I'll pin a comment below this video. So if both features are available, I feel like Automobilista 2 has an edge over Project Cars 2 here. But for now, it won't receive the point. Finally, the last category reviews the amount of content available in both games, as well as the quality of eventual single player modes. Automobilista 2's whole single player mode consists of a championship, where you can compete against AI opponents on a set race calendar. This championship is obviously available for multiple car classes. However, that's about it for the single player. Except the all-time classics single race, test day, aka practice session, and time trial, which features an online leaderboard. Apart from this, there are currently about 110 cars and 39 tracks available, but a 40th one is set to be released this year. These numbers are not too shabby, but not quite up to par with Project Cars 2's roster, that consists of 125 cars and 60 tracks. Furthermore, it has to be mentioned that while Project Cars 2 features tracks like the Circuit of the Americas, Barcelona or Le Mans, Automobilista 2 features a lot of Brazilian tracks, or rather, less known tracks in general. On the other hand, even though AMS 2 has lesser known tracks, there are historic versions for almost all of them, including my personal favorite, the 1974 Red Bull Ring. Regarding single player modes, Project Cars 2 also has the all-time classics, but profits from an amazing single player campaign that has you starting in karting or a lower tier racing series and climb the ranks to the top, promoting you to the next tier via a contract offer when you deliver good results. In terms of content and single player modes, Project Cars 2 clearly has the upper hand, as it features more well-known circuits and has probably the best single player campaign in any racing game out there, with the exception of the F1 series, of course. So to sum it all up, for now, Project Cars 2 wins the direct comparison 3-2. However, if Reiza manages to keep their promises and finally implement the multiplayer rating system, as well as the option to be able to race every track car combination online without owning the according DLC, Automobilista 2 is going to turn the multiplayer category in its favor and therefore also the final scoreline, winning with 3-2. If you're more of a person that just likes to sit down and create own offline sessions doing hot laps or racing the eye, then you need to evaluate the present tracks in both games for yourself, as both are great for this purpose. However, if you're more serious about experiencing a more realistic driving experience regarding physics, you should definitely head over to Automobilista 2. And when racing against other folks is your main concern, then Project Cars 2 has a wider range of open lobbies and about twice as much players per day than Automobilista 2. Lastly, if Formula cars are what you really care about and you're okay with neglecting a wider range of GT3 and GT4 cars, I can only recommend AMS 2, as for me, this game is the ultimate Formula simulator. So yeah, that's it for this comparison. If you happen to enjoy it or got something useful out of it, you could consider subscribing to this channel for more sim racing content. And with that said, I'll catch you in the next one. Cheers!